Hey y'all, I'm Mickey Gousset. Now last video, I showed you how to migrate a single repository using the GitHub Enterprise Importer. This video, I'm gonna show you how you can use the importer to create a script that will migrate multiple repos for you. Let's get to it. So to get started migrating multiple repositories, we have a couple of ways potentially to do it, right? One way is we do a ghgi. If you remember, we're running this migrate repo command. So we could just add a bunch of those commands into a script file, like a bash file or a PowerShell file, and then run those commands in that file. Luckily, we've actually automated that process for you. So if we do a ghgei dash dash help, then you can see that there is a command here called generate script. And what that generate script command does is it generates a migration script for you. It will go and look at an entire organization, and then it will generate a PowerShell, used to be PowerShell Core, now it's whatever it's called now, but it's cross-platform PowerShell. So it'll run on Linux, it'll run on Windows, it'll run on Mac. And what it will do is it will go to that organization, it will list out all the repositories in that organization, and then it will create this script that will migrate all the repositories if you want to. Now, I like using this method because it creates this script that I can then edit to allow me to migrate my repositories in chunks. So maybe I migrate all of a particular team's repositories. And it makes it easy to rename the repositories as part of the migration. So let's clear this out. Let's do a ghgei generate script dash dash help and see what the different options are. So you can see we provided the source org and we provided the target org. Then we have some other options here, like if we're migrating from enterprise server, then we need the API URL, we need the bucket name or the AWS bucket that we're using to store things in. We can ignore SSL if we want to. We have the ability to download the migration logs for each repository. So after each repository runs, we can download the migration logs. We have the ability to skip releases like we did before, lock the repos like we did before. Output changes the name of the output file. By default, it's migrate.ps1, but you could change it to any file name you wanted to. It just needs to end in a .ps1. And what's going to happen is you'll see is it's going to try to run a bunch of these migrations in parallel, but if you want them to run in sequential, you can by throwing that switch right there. So let's actually run this, right? So to run this, we're gonna say ghgei generate script dash dash github dash source org. So my source organization is DevOps Elvis. And then dash dash github dash target org. And my target organization is Mickey dash Volcano. Remember, I'm migrating from my enterprise cloud to my enterprise managed users environment. And then I'm just going to hit return. And it's going to go out. It's going to find all of the repositories that I have in my source org. And it's going to generate a script for me. And we can see it generated a migrate.ps1 script. So let's open that script up in VS Code. Give that just a moment to open. And what we're going to do is review what the script is doing, and then we're going to make some changes to it. Now, this first part of the script right here, don't worry about that just yet. We'll come back to that. The script is broken into multiple sections. The first section is queuing up all the repository migrations. Now what we've done is for each repository, we are running the migrate repo command. So we're saying ghgei migrate repo, provide it the source organization, the source repo name. Then we provide it the target organization and the target repo name. Now this is where, let's say I was migrating this Mickey internal toolbox. I want to change the name. I could change the name. So in each of these lines for each repo that you've decided to migrate, you can also change what the name is going to be in the target repository. And then we're using that switch queue only. So we're not going to wait for it to finish like we did when we ran a single migration previously in the previous video. We're going to just queue it up, fire and forget for right now. And we're also going to set the target visibility. In this case, we're setting the target visibility to private. But on this one, you'll see we're trying to set it to public. However, Enterprise Managed users don't allow public repositories, so we'll change this one to be private as well. Now, you'll notice that we're wrapping that or calling this execute and get migration ID. So what's happening is we're calling this function right up here, which is going to run the GEI command and get the migration ID back. Because with that migration ID, we can track the migration process. And then we're going to just shove that migration ID into an array. Now I changed the name of the repository, so I like to change the name of my array to be the same thing. You don't have to, but I like to. You could also leave it just source names if you wanted to. Now, as you can see, we have all the repositories from that organization, but I don't necessarily want to migrate all the repositories from that organization right now. If I was going to migrate all the repositories from the organization, I could also use another command in the Enterprise Importer tool that migrates an entire organization at once. Now that also has some pros and cons to consider. But for now, what I want to do is just migrate a subset of repos. So let's migrate these first two repositories, and then let's go down until we find the My Shuttle repository that we've been migrating. Should be right there. So what I'm going to do is remove all of these repos and then remove the rest of these repositories all the way down to when I get to the next section, which is waiting for the migrations to finish. So I'm only going to migrate these three repositories. So what happens is it will queue up those three repositories. That's what's happening here in the queuing. And then it's going to wait for those repositories to finish. Now, I changed the name of this one here. So I also need to change it here and here and also here so that it matches everywhere. I could have left that name the same. As you can see with the other two, I left the name. It didn't really matter. Now, before I explain what's going on here, let's go find the My Shuttle. There it is. And then let's delete the rest of these, because I only need to check to see if migrations are finished for the three that I'm migrating in this case. And then we've got a summary section. Now what we're doing here after we queue up the migrations is we need to watch for them to finish. So we're checking, hey, has this one finished? And we do that by saying ghgei, wait for migration to complete. We give it that migration ID that we set earlier. And if that one finishes, we'll output whether it's successful or failed, and then we'll go on and check the next one. And the next one may be finished by the time we get to it, in which case we'll then just get the output and move to the next one. And then finally, we have a summary section where we'll write out the number that succeeded and the number that failed. Now, I don't ever like to edit the original file. I like to have the original file to use in the future so that we could then, you know, take another subset of repositories and migrate those. So what I'm going to do is do a file save as, and I will save this as my, we'll just say migrate-edited.ps1 file. So we'll save that. And so now if we close this, and we do an ls, you'll see that we do have our migrate-edited.ps1 file. Now, one thing we need to make sure we do is we need to make that file where it's execute can be executed. So we'll do a change mod plus x migrate-edited.ps1. Now, you need to make sure you have PowerShell installed on your Linux environment if you're running in Linux, which I do. So we can just do a /migrate-edited.ps1. Let's clear out the screen first. /migrate. And since we have the environment variables already set for accessing the source environment, obviously, because you saw that, and the target environment, then it's going to queue up the migrations. So it's queuing up internal toolbox first. Here's the RMID for that. Remember, this is the migration ID that you'll need that lets you know what's happening with the migration, or that you can use to give to support, or if you're working with GitHub Services or a partner or with my Fast Track team, so that we can determine what's happening with your migration. You can see it queued up the GitHub Actions demo, and then it also queued up the My Shuttle. And now it is watching for the migrations to complete. So it's watching that first one. Let's see, which one is it watching? It's watching this one, ZWM, which is this first one. So now we're watching until my internal toolbox completes its migration. So we're going to sit and we're going to wait and we're going to let this whole thing run so you can see what happens through the whole process. And then we'll look at some of the results after the migration. But as you can see, this makes it really easy to migrate batches of repositories at a time, which is great for if you're trying to move for specific teams at once, you can migrate all of their repositories at once. Now, keep in mind, there's still a bunch of post steps that will need to happen as well, because you'll need to do things. Oh, you'll see this one finished. Toolbox finished. That the other ones are still running, and now they've all finished. So all three of them have finished. We've had three successful migrations. Now, if we go back over to where we migrated and do a refresh, then you'll see we've got all three migrated. Now, these two were archived repositories in the old system, so it did keep them archived in the new system, which you would expect. And here's the My Shuttle with the two issues and the one pull request, just like we've seen in previous videos. But as I was saying, there are still a bunch of post steps you're going to potentially have to do, such as setting up security. For example, if I look at this migrated repository, the only security it sets up is because I ran the migration, it adds me as an admin. Well, that may not be how we have it actually want to have it set, right? We may want to have teams that have access to this repo, or we may want to have specific people. So the migration, when you're migrating individual repositories or groups of repositories, it doesn't migrate security. So that is a post-migration step that you'll have to do. You may need to, if you're not going to be using GitHub Actions, you may need to configure integration into Jenkins or Azure Pipelines so that you can integrate with whatever third-party systems you're needing to integrate with. Now, if we go back and look at the command line, just to remind you, We do get the log files that are there. We do, which will show you if you go into the verbose logs, it will show you all the API calls that are being made. You can also download the log files for the migrations if you want to. And we talked about the other options on the generate script. But just to remind you, there are other options on the generate script, such as being able to lock the repositories, or instead of running this in parallel, running things in a sequential mode. There you go. Using the Enterprise Importer, we can create a script that will migrate multiple repositories for us. And then this makes it pretty easy to say, take all of a team's repos and migrate them all at once. Now, next up, we're going to be looking at things like how you can migrate an entire organization. And then we're going to need to look at how you can handle those pesky mannequin users we talked about a couple of videos back. We have a lot more to cover, so stick with me. Thanks for watching.